Sabote, this is Jeff.
This is David.
We are playing Darksiders 2.
Yes.
You will recall from last time that we went, we completed the Kingdom of the Dead.
Okay. Woo!
We just very briefly stepped into Lost Light, the third major world. But we're going to forget all that. We're going to do a DLC campaign for this episode and the next.
Woo!
Yeah! Which means this is all non-canon because we'll be reverting our save file because we had to update the save file. So this is a patched version of the game now.
Oh, so war is or war?
Yeah,
death.
It's that other guy, death. Yeah,
death is less awesome.
Yeah, we don't have our ridiculous stat boosts, which means this is occasionally extremely difficult. That's okay. We do have the rest. We have all of our stuff. We have our Terminus Est.
Right.
And so forth. This DLC, as we've already started the DLC, you see it's kind of a unceremonious.
Yeah.
Just dumps you in there. You choose the campaign from the main menu. It brings in your stats and weapons. So we're making a new weapon to get started with here. And the main focus of this weapon is to have ice damage. Because ice damage is really good.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to call it the Terminus Best.
I hate you.
The Terminus Best. Also,
I
that
hate
ominous
you.
That ominous little zoom in. We'll go back to come back to that later. The Terminus Best will end up not being the best for a very specific and odd reason that has to do with glitches in the game, but. We'll
That's what
that
you
later.
Get for that pun.
Yeah. We'll come back to it. So when you start into one of the DLC campaigns, this is the one that's called the Abyssal Forge, right?
Okay.
Mad Smith is the character that you meet. Okay, so this is called the Abyssal Forge. You just choose it for the main menu, and it just puts you here in this area.
Okay.
And then you
Great.
Play what amounts to about 1.5 dungeons and a boss fight.
Oh,
so
all right.
The DLC, all of the DLC campaigns, of which there are 3, have the same setup where you just kind of get dumped into an area without even like an introduction cutscene or anything. It's just, hey, now you're in this sort of. Looks
we
like-
had these art assets in this dungeon plan, so here.
Yeah, fortunately, it's a new. Like, it's a new look.
Yeah.
It's basically a swamp, but still, it's a different, you know, different palette. It's
yeah.
gray-green. I mean, it's different.
It has the look of rot.
Mm-hmm.
Which is fine.
So, the basic premise of this is the Matt Smith made Missile Forge, which is making monsters... constructs, and you need to destroy it.
Okay.
The Matt Smith, because I'm sure you remember exactly who that is. He was mentioned once in one of the talismans we got as like, this was forged by the Matt Smith.
Oh. Yes.
I forget which one that was specifically, but oh well. Also, when you start one of these campaigns, it gives you a set of abilities by default. So we have the gun, we have the soul splitter.
Do you have the Reachy Army Grabby thing?
Yes, I do believe we have the Reachy Army Grabby thing. That's also the reason I didn't want to do this until now. There's different parts in the story where this would make sense. Like, normally I would put this, you know, with the pushing my statue out of the way. Normally, it would make sense to put this sort of at the end of the Forge Land, since it does have, you know, at least a maker in it.
Right.
But it doesn't really, it's not, there's no continuity, so it doesn't really matter. Plus, I didn't want to spoil the other ability you get. Super secret one that you can't figure out. It's a secret to everyone.
Visitor. I'm afraid my home is quite a mess.
Speak plainly if you value your life such as it is.
Oh, how rude of me. I am a smith, a visionary architect, sculptor, creator of the masterpiece that resides in this realm. And you must be an agent of the Makers. They've trapped me here for thousands of years. Now they think my death will ease them. They are not forgiven.
Start off with a boss fight.
Great.
Yay. See, missing. This didn't happen. All right, so for the very first time, let's fight the boss.
Yes.
I don't do a lot of damage anymore. Sad.
Yeah, those numbers look reasonable.
Yeah, like every time I hit him, his health bar only goes down a little bit.
Right.
He basically has the same moveset as Thane. Except he also has the spinning AoE attack, which is what kind of killed me from full health, almost.
What level are you supposed to be for this stuff?
I don't really know. I assume that it scales. Yeah, that thing. Dangerous. I'm going to assume it scales because you can play this at any time.
Okay.
Like any of the DLC stuff. But, I don't really know. I can't really be bothered to figure that out.
Right.
This
it
is just an amusing...
seem worth it.
Yeah, it's an amusing aside.
All right, I have to ask, what accent is this guy supposed to have?
Well, it's definitely not the Maker accent that you want.
I know. That's why I'm mad.
He's certainly a lot closer to a Wicked K than he is to a Aedard.
Yeah. It's just, like, it's not Scottish, it's not, like, that Willie Nelson-ish, rough, voicey thing.
It's definitely some sort of British. Maybe
yeah.
just your standard received pronunciation.
Yeah. It's just, it's not, like, some sort of British, like, an actual person from, oh, cutscene.
he died, it, but not really, because,
yeah, of course not.
Wait, please. Must wait. You attacked me, Smith. A madness has blinded you. Mad, am I? Now, let us not be ruled by our baser instincts. We can help each other. Answer my questions and I will stay my hand. I won't ask again. Where are we?
This is the Shadowlands. A void between the Tree of Life and the Tree of Death. It's a rather pleasant place for a visit, is it not? Or an eon of imprisonment, as it were?
You're such a genius, why haven't you escaped?
Transportation is no obstacle for a smith such as myself. But the Makers have sealed the portal. Or so I had thought.
Power of corruption has broken the lock of your prison.
But how? I don't... Oh, gods, what will it do? Wait! Don't leave! You have to help me.
Why?
My masterpiece! It threatens countless worlds! The Abyssal Forge is a sentient being of living stone, and it has crafted an implacable army.
If the portal seal is unlocked, creations of the Abyssal Forge will invade other realms.
How is this any of my concern?
Ah, you don't understand! I crafted the Abyssal Forge to harness the power of the Abyss. It lives, it breathes, it creates constructs that can then build yet more abyssal forges! unlike myself, the abyssal forge is utterly insane. Its constructs will destroy everything in their path.
You should not have meddled with the powers of the abyss. You must unmake this.
I have tried, yet I cannot.
Damn you. What must be done, then?
Jess is just like...
This is JRPG levels of stupid. This is... Oh, that's so dumb. That's amazing. That's my favorite plot point now. And he's your shop. That's...
Yes, he's also a shop. Yes.
Oh, that's... Oh, I love... That's good. All right.
So there you go, that's the entire premise. There's a few, I'm going to put this in air quotes, quests we have to do. First one is just collecting 7 things in order to make a key so that we can get to the next area.
Oh, it's 7? Not 3? Not 9? Not 6?
I think it's 7. Yeah.
Wow. Maybe 2 of them are already collected for you and he just doesn't tell you? Like, That's weird. Why would it?
No, no. We have to find Chaos Ore, okay, so that he can make us a talisman to get across the poisonous swamps.
Why don't
which will kill
impotent,
you within...
Why don't you just impotent jump across and say, screw this fetch quest?
Can do that, sort of.
Oh, textures.
The easy version of that doesn't work anymore.
Oh, they fixed that.
The hard version still does, where you have to do
the dash jump thing.
Yeah, dash jump frame precise thing. Fortunately, I really love this dungeon, because it has, like different levels.
Hmm.
You know, like, little platforms over platforms, and...
All right.
There's not a lot of safety rails, but, you know.
It's... Considering who built it, not shocking. This guy... I don't know. Emperor Palpatine levels of crazy, stupid, evil. Don't know. Just...
Those red crystals in the background are the ones we're looking for.
Okay.
We just find 7 of those. I do like Quagmire from Equinox, so... This reminds me of that. Just a little bit.
Just a little bit.
More mechanical. More iron.
Right. I'm trying to remember which one Quagmire was.
Quagmire. Quagmire.
What'd I say?
Quagmire is
no,
what I heard.
I said Quag. It should have been Quag.
All right.
I thought Quag.
Yeah, plenty of opportunities to mess up the English language. I'll give you that one.
Right. Which one was Quagmire?
Quagmire was the overgrown mansion.
Okay, got it. That was like 4 years ago, so...
Yes, accurate.
Also a game I never played. I watched you play it, but...
It's true. We have new enemies, which are just, you know, reskins. In this case, they explode.
All right.
And then we have some good, some... just kind of wrote Soul Splitter puzzles. For the most part, they're interesting.
Okay.
There's only one that sort of redoes a gimmick.
Okay. I will say I do like how their enemy design is kind of like the Muppets, where if you don't know what to do to make it different or how to end a skit, just blow everything up.
Yep, that's the design for these particular enemies.
If it works, man.
So the three DLCs for Darksiders 2 would have made the original game a lot better. As it is now, they're kind of just a gigantic ripoff, especially if you have the console version and you had to pay for them.
Yeah.
I guess the PC version does have everything included with it.
Yeah, it does.
So that does make it a better deal, especially since this thing is $10 and we're going to be done with it in an hour.
Oh.
Yeah, so each one of the three expansions is $10 by itself, you know, like at least on the console version. Mm-hmm. The first one, the Argyle's Tomb, comes with new copies of the game, or at least it did.
Mm-hmm.
So that one I did already have. And I've not played the third one, but I imagine it's kind of the same setup.
Yeah.
I mean, that being said, if it were integrated into the game more properly, it would make for more interesting and varied dungeons, because this would be I assume would be in the Forge Land somewhere.
Well, it says it's between the...
Yeah, the portal, so I guess it could be stuck somewhere in the... after you find the Tree of Life.
And you go through, just like maybe one of the random times you go between...
Yeah. I mean, they could easily, have a thing, maybe just... Oh, I don't know, let's design a quest. You get maybe one of the talismans from Muria diverts you into this area by accident when you go through the Tree of Life. Something like that.
Yeah, sure. Or she even gives you a talisman.
Yeah, or just straight
like,
up tells you.
This guy is crazy and he may be JRPG stupid.
And using my blind powers, I can tell he's been futzing with the Abyss or something. Right.
And considering I decided to make an eternally burning being full of hatred, and I think what he did is a bad idea.
Yes, and I think it didn't go well. So, if you could go take care of that guy, that'd be great.
Please. Also, he has the wrong accent, and it's...
Yeah, it's really... It's that's the reason we are sort of not cool with him. It's a... I mean, I guess the self, you know, self-replicating sort of monster like, construct thing.
All,
I guess
all the worst
bad.
Parts of the replicants and the Borg put together, yes.
Yeah. That's sort of bad for other, you know, other races, but yeah. For the Makers, the real problem is that he doesn't have a right accent. We can't really suffer that, so if you could just go murder him, that'd be fantastic.
I'd believe Mirio would do that. Everyone else probably would be against it, but she's heartless.
Let's get some appropriate defense here.
The Emino Bolgnir?
Yep, we gotta bring out the Bolgnir for this.
Sounds good.
Some more reskins of enemies. Or actually, it's not even really a reskin, it just has explosions. That's sort of the...
It's the Muppets.
Yeah,
it's the Muppet version. That's
they
fine.
Added explosions to enemies for this particular dungeon. The fire status effect, burning status effect, sucks. It's so bad. It's terrible.
Yeah, but
it causes you to stagger, and it just kind of
will oh, it does staggering too. Oh,
and it just takes off like a third of your health. This makes the actual Abyssal Forge boss really annoying.
Oh, because he also lights you on fire.
Yeah, it's a whole fire thing. Fire and explosions.
I kinda figured,
but...
Kind
of a theme.
Yeah.
Fortunately, we can warp up to them.
Which
also,
is...
ice is really good.
Yeah, I've noticed you've been using the crows for that. Ow.
We also have our Terminus Best for freezing things.
I can't wait to see why that screws you over. Really can't.
Yeah, this is a mystery to everyone. Those constructs are... Although it's been a while since we've seen them in the LP, they tend to walk through your attacks when they're on the ground, but if you kick them up into the air, they're helpless. So,
yeah. Are you going to take off the Give Me Red Things talisman?
Yeah.
You got enough red things?
Yeah, we've got enough red things, and the red things we do have are just going to be wasted because we're going to go back to a previous save file anyways.
Right.
Alas.
Alas and alack.
As it were, so be it.
As it is, as it
as
were.
As it is, as it were.
As it would be.
So it will be.
Twill.
So it shall come to pass.
Twill is what really sells that, so it twill be.
Twill be. Okay.
Not it will, but twill.
That sounds like a fantasy hat.
A twilby instead of a trilby.
Yep. That's,
possibly.
Yep, that's pretty sure that was an omelure. It's probably an omelure.
It probably is.
Somewhere in there.
It's been a while since I played the game.
It does have two apostrophes in it as well. I don't know if you could hear that in the name, but...
I could.
Okay.
I like the angry faces on the door. It makes me think that's what the Mad Smith used to look like, so because he had all this time, all the doors were just going to have his angry face on it.
Yes, that's how he designed the place.
My angry face, yeah.
Now we get to roll a ball around.
So you're a cat. Or a dung beetle, honestly.
Yeah, more of a dung beetle.
Yeah. You don't eat it, so... Well, they don't really eat it either. That's more for... Last I read up on them, it was more for mating purposes, but I don't really read up on them often.
Why not? Why aren't you reading it right now? I'm going to read about a dung beetle right now.
All right, go for it.
I read Wikipedia. What have you got for me? Let's see, I'm going to just scroll to a random spot in here and get just some hot knowledge and just dump it on you.
All right, let's hear it.
Let's see.
Oh, so are you just doing inventory management right now?
Yes.
And you left it in because?
I don't remember.
Okay. All right, let's hear about ding puddles.
Is any of these trivia points interesting?
Dung beetles, so probably not. I think they're fascinating, but I'm lonely and sad.
Several species of the dung beetle, most notably the species Scarabaeus sacer, or sacer.
How do you spell it?
The first part or the last part?
Sacer, whatever.
S-A-C-E-R.
S-A-C-E-R.
It's gonna be
saucer, sacer, either one.
Yeah, it's gonna be a hard C because Latin, because it's a Latin name for it. But.
All right. Continue.
It was enjoyed a sacred status from the ancient Egyptians.
Because it was a scarab beetle.
Sacer being sacred.
Yeah.
Beetle. Okay.
All right.
If you wanted to know how to say sacred scarab in Latin, Scarabaeus sacer. There you go.
All right.
Also, that might be one of the other dead lords that didn't make the cut. Honestly.
Possibly. That would have been an interesting fight. Comes at you like Katamari Damacy, and you just don't want to get rolled up in it.
Yeah, you have to dodge, otherwise you just get caught up in the ball.
Oh, that'd be gross. That'd
Ew.
Be really gross. Though I'm sure Wincott would have some great lines.
Yes. He always has good lines. Look at that. That guy didn't get staggered by anything.
No,
he kicked
him
up in the air.
He's just
so annoying. Explosive beetles.
I like how those little rotating things, the only reason they exist. Rotate up, drop beetles. Rotate down.
I'm going to pretend that the beetle finished that guy off.
Yeah. Yeah.
Explosion radius on that is too big.
If you were making a design decision. You would make the explosion radius smaller?
Yes. Yes, I would. Or just increase the iframes on the dodge. I don't know.
You can never have too many iframes. Well, you can, but that's not the point. I assume you can? I've never made a game before.
Too many. I guess you could have too many, but then you would just be invincible. I think that's just what it would end up being.
I guess that's fine. All right, you never can. There are times when I like a game with literally zero challenge.
That's true.
That's why I play Minecraft. Because it's only as challenging.
I don't know. It's challenging as you make it. So
yeah, it is as challenging as my OCD demands, and OCD being that playful. Oh, I have OCD. Not like I actually have. Ooh, good job pulling that off.
Yeah, thank you. We're gonna go on top here for no apparent reason.
All right.
Just because, why not?
This looks slightly more fleshed out than normal.
It's perhaps the there is a lot of places you can walk around on top of everything here. This is just to show that yes, even though it was DLC released after the game, it's still made by the same people. So, there's consistency here.
Yeah. Wow. It's a nice set piece. I don't know if I like the skybox as much, though. I mean, it still looks good, I guess. It's just not as awesome as the Land of the Dead or Maker Place. Forge Lands.
Maker Forge Place thing. Person.
I've had a rough week, all right?
Yes, I understand. It's okay. This one time.
Just one time I get away with it.
You can butcher the English language, and I will only make fun of you just a little bit.
Good to know.
Just a close-up, some more Chaos Ore.
Yeah.
Yay.
It's
just a reason, or it's just the easiest way to make a non-linear dungeon, put in air quotes.
Yeah.
Is to have, you have to collect these seven things, don't really care where or when or how you get them, but you do have to get them.
This looks like another combat arena.
Yeah, imagine that.
Huh.
We have some more
interference is unacceptable.
There would be the Abyssal Forge muttering at us.
So it is the Borg.
Kind of. It's a little bit more like a... A little bit more like a Reaper from Mass Effect.
Okay. All right. Actually, what I was probably thinking was, like, the attitude of the Borg with the replication ability of the replicants from Stargate.
Mm-hmm.
But that's because everything has to be related some way to a sci-fi TV show that I watched when I was younger.
Well, to be fair, Star Trek and Stargate cover pretty much all of the basic sci-fi plots.
That's true. And for everything else, there's Babylon 5 and Farscape, though I know you don't like Farscape.
Speaking of puppets...
I hate you. So are we fighting a construct now?
Yeah, these are just slightly more fiery versions of the, I don't know, just the heavy versions of those guys. I forget what they were called. Their boards or something.
Their design and attack pattern reminds me of the fat baby things from Devil May Cry.
The fat babies.
The big ones, they charged you. I was really bad at them. You shot their bags.
Yeah. Okay, the Tyrants, I think.
Yes,
I think
Tyrants.
That's what they're
called. Yes. Yeah. Just because they had the charge and the...
Yeah.
Yeah.
And they run into you, and it pauses for 3 frames and goes, Tunk!
Yes, that.
Ah, good times. Those guys are also completely helpless when you get them in the air.
And every game.
Yeah, I don't think you got far enough to get unlock the... I think maybe you did. Yeah, you did. Yeah, you must have, yeah. You did beat it, right?
I beat the game. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So
I beat the game and the DLC.
So you did, in fact. It's the second level, the charged second level uppercut is what will launch. One of the few things that will launch them.
Yeah. I wasn't good at it, but I could do it.
Totally do it.
It was possible.
Yes. It was conceivable. It was feasible. It was
just not likely, but... So, the Chaos Orbs just seems like random and...
Random and unexplained? Yeah, kinda.
Yeah, it's more just the design of it that I don't... I guess red equals chaos?
I guess so, yeah. I mean, I can get behind that.
I guess.
So we finished a leg of the dungeon, so here's our shortcut back to the beginning.
It's good to know that thing survived under there all that time.
Yeah.
Good
it's
on
apparently,
it.
Apparently it's acidic only towards flesh and not towards iron?
Is that iron or stone? That looked like stone.
Stone? Steel? Iron? I don't know. I guess it could be stone. I guess I associated this with most of it. More of like a... Iron Keep kind of thing.
Yeah.
Except with Louisiana swamp instead of lava.
Oh, I did make it to the Iron Keep. You're right. I have made it to that area. I get that reference.
I get that reference. Speaking of things that are more interesting than this dungeon at the moment, did you ever see Winter Soldier?
No, I didn't. I really wanted to, but I have not had time to go see movies.
Yeah, I guess that's true.
Easter's really busy when you work at a church.
Okay, yeah. You gotta make sure you're ready for all the people that only go to church twice a year.
Well, it's not even that. It's more just along the lines of, well, it's Easter, so people expect you to do a lot more. Which is understandable.
That.
It's an important thing, so you have a lot of extra stuff going on. But it's also anytime there's new music at all, guess who has to make sure it's right for everybody and all that? It's me!
Is that guy.
That's
here's another reskin. This time they're made of metal.
Yay!
And they set you on fire, which sucks.
Just touching you? Or are there attacks?
They're attacks.
Okay,
on fire. As
good.
You can see, I'm just constantly losing health. This whole fight is just pain.
So, Reaper mode.
Yep.
Oh, And you ran out of Reaper mode, and it's not dead. Oh, there it goes.
Weird. When I came in, nope, not to wait for the cutscene. When I came in, I was trying to skip it by just going straight to the,
I assume that's what it was, but...
But it didn't work out. It might have worked out, I don't know. If it's possible or not.
This wasn't worth the effort.
Do some fighting. Fighting's fine.
It's fun! That's presumably a reason to play the game.
It is a reason, yeah. Winter Soldier's really good. You should watch it.
I really liked just Captain America a lot. Mm-hmm. So I figured
Captain America was my favorite of the first of the first Avengers' movies.
Yeah. I also liked Thor a whole lot. I know I was kind of in the minority there, apparently.
I didn't even see Thor.
It was really good. It set up Loki really well.
I did see The Dark World, which is very entertaining.
Yeah, I haven't seen that. There are a lot of movies I need to see, and I just haven't. And there are movies I actually do want to see.
And they're actually ones you want to see, which is unusual for a movie.
But they're comic book movies. It's a no-brainer for me. That's I watch those.
Let me solve a puzzle.
Did you solve it?
Yep, I did it.
All right, yeah. How'd you collect that?
It's convenient that Chaos Orb, when you destroy it, it flies through the air towards the direction of the thing or person that destroyed it.
That's a very specific trait to have.
It flies towards the direction of the person responsible for destroying it, because the thing that destroyed it was the actual bomb.
Well, it still kind of flew towards the bomb plant.
I guess that's, yeah, okay. You can make that argument, all right. I am no expert in Forgeland biology, so.
So seeing all these curvy bits.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Yep.
Yep. It's kind of weird. I mean, I guess it's amusing.
Yeah.
I mean, there's no real puzzle here. It's just keep rolling it until it decides to actually stay up top.
Oh, I thought it was going to be a lot more fun than that.
Yeah, I thought so too, but eventually we'll just, yeah, stick there like it's supposed to.
Aw.
Yeah,
I was really hoping it was going to be like some crazy pinball machine.
Unfortunately not.
And like you'd eventually like end up activating bumpers and...
Yes.
Apropos of nothing, but at this
point,
who cares?
You would get a score at the end, and it would mean nothing.
Oh, no, this just seems a little tedious.
Yep.
Aww. Aww. Are you trying to see if it'll hurt you?
It does not.
Aww.
Fortunately or unfortunately.
I don't know, that would... You know what, if it hurt you, I'd be saying that's terrible, but at the same time, now that it doesn't, I still think that's terrible.
Yep.
So, I'm going to go with the me of present and say that's terrible.
I'm going to go with the me of present. I think I'll add that to the old notepad file.
My mastery of the English language. Remember, people pay money to hear me talk.
That's true. People have literally paid money for that. How interesting.
Yeah.
Doesn't seem very pointful.
No, it's not very pointful. Are you actually keeping a word pad?
It's not a word pad, it's a notepad. Okay? It's a text file.
Oh, God.
And yes.
I actually said pointful?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's great. All right. Oh, you got a little...
We have a fight.
Oh. All right.
We've got a bunch of them. This is fun, because you can just knock around a bunch of dudes.
Ah. All those numbers lining up almost look like one of the ridiculous numbers I'm used to seeing.
Our high execution chance will also make this easy. Or easier, anyways. Freezing dudes and executing them.
I don't know what's going on.
There's a lot of B button prompts.
Alright.
Just assume that it ends in instant kills.
Alright. So when is execution chance proc?
That's a good question. I don't really know how that works. I'm going to assume you can only get an execution after they've been damaged a certain amount. Hey, there's another guy here.
I was wondering if it was like once they're at a quarter health or a third health is when it'll start proccing, or...
I really don't know how it works. I also don't know when it takes the sort of like the random number generator for that. Mm. Like, is it each time you hit them with the scythe, it has a chance, and then if it procs, then at a certain health threshold, it will turn to the prompt? Or it only starts checking after a certain threshold is met. I don't really know.
All right.
All I know is that when you have a high execution chance, they die real fast, real soon.
Which, as Squishy, that took a long time. As squishy as you are, that's kind of important.
This is what you require.
Ah, good, 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 yes. Oh, behold, Rider! This talisman is beyond the skill of most makers. Almost too fine for one such as you.
Enough. Tell me how to destroy the Abyssal Forge.
Destroy the Hearthstone, of course.
Consider it done.
Yay, we got the Madsmith device. Fortunately, this is a passive.
Okay.
We do not have to equip it and unequip it if we want to walk across the acid.
I will say that guy sounded almost like the Joker for a second. I was about to really like him.
Alas.
Yeah.
Well, that's the first half of the Abyssal Forge. Join us next time on Let's Play Darksiders 2, where we will actually fight the Abyssal Forge. And the way you beat it is by hitting it in the face.
That's so shocking.
Until its health bar is gone. Not like you do any other boss. But that's next time on Stop recording now.
Right. I wasn't sure if there was an end to that.